Catch a falling star and put it in your pocket, never let it fade away. Catch a falling star and put it in your pocket, save it for a rainy day. For love may come and tap you on the shoulder some starless night. Just in case you feel you wanna hold her, you'll have a pocket full of starlight. Catch a falling star and put it in your pocket, never let it fade away.
This is East Road and Adam, the house that they lived in when I first met them.
I think you were up here gathering. It was at this house.
Got sick.
Mm-hmm.
And how old was John? John was born there.
John was born. Yeah, he was actually born in Gardner, but we lived in the hospital in Gardner. But we were living in Orange at the time. He was 5 months old.
He was 5 months old.
Yeah.
And that was totally unexpected. Not
totally unexpected.
Not anything you had planned, or anything that you would have ever thought would happen to you.
That's right.
And so in that, what year was that?
That was 1941.
1941, you became a single parent long before single parents
were popular.
Were helped out or sought out.
That's right.
Had allowances made for them. And so John really never got to know his father other than by his reputation.
That's right.
And you decided you would like, you had to move home and be here. Was your father alive then?
Oh, yes.
So you moved back to
Dennis
for you. And had to go to work?
I went to work.
Back in the day. Well, they were probably happy to have you, but
oh,
not
they
under
called.
Those circumstances.
Oh, yeah. They called. Would you,
would you come back? And what did you, you work in the office there?
Yes.
Just general office kind of work?
Yes, right.
And so John stayed with your parents during the day?
Mm-hmm. And then, of course, the underground one closed.
Soon after that?
Oh, I was there again.
Looking for employment again. And how old was John then?
Like 2 or 3.
So he had the benefit of living in a multi-generational family.
Yes, he did.
And you had the support of your parents. Of course, you always were a very strong person anyway, but, I mean, to go through that at your age must have been very difficult.
It wasn't easy.
And like I say, back then when there weren't many
hopes
single,
and dreams. And
that was before the war.
Yeah.
I mean, I'm sure after the war there were widows of war people, but
who had lost. Same as I did.
Uh-huh.
Used to write to Mother a lot, and one day she said, wrote a letter about somebody that she knew who had, whose husband had died, and he left four children. Well, that was really
no, that wasn't sure that's supposed to make you feel better,
but it didn't. I can imagine. But anyhow, so you lived up there, you do what you have to do, Barbara.
Right,
you survive and get along.
And then after your father died, you and your mother were looking for help.
Looking for an apartment, and then she saw this and she liked it. And she thought it would be nice to come to Adams because I worked in Adams.
Mm-hmm. So you had been, you were working at a different place then?
Yes, after the print works closed, I started looking again, and I went to work down at, Ballymine and Adams. I only went to work there for the simple reason that it paid the best.
Mm-hmm. you needed to support yourself at that point.
It's $25 a week and started working there, and no place in your band is paid anywhere.
Now, was John almost school age by the time you moved to Adams? Did he start going to school here?
No. We didn't move here until 1958.
Oh, so he was already in elementary school.
He was through high school.
Oh, he was.
58. Just graduated.
So he was getting ready to go off to college.
Yes, he was.
So it was you and your mom.
Mm-hmm. Just
after he left. Mm-hmm. And now John went to college in Illinois, Indiana.
No, he graduated from Worcester Polytech.
Oh, okay.
He went there in 58. And he went there in 62. Then he went on a teaching fellowship out to Purdue for 2 years and got his master's out there.
And what year did your mother die?
63.
And then you were here by yourself?
Yes.
Because John was away already?
Yes, he was away. Yeah. He was he graduated in 64. And back then, you did not have to look for work. They were looking
for him.
Mm-hmm. And so he had many opportunities, which I always thought he should have taken, but that's beside the point. NASA was going to put him through for his education.
So, but at that point, you didn't expect him ever to come back home and live?
I never expected him. I didn't feel that he should. Away.
Serves his life and make his own way in the world.
So anyway, what he did, he chose research in Sprague.
Mm-hmm.
He had to be. I think he did it mostly because
to be close to home.
See, he had worked there summers
during school.
During school, yes. And so then, of course, they hired him full time down the research lab in Sprague. And then he worked there until 1968. And at that time, there was starting to be a big cutback in Sprague. I think they were beginning to. And he saw the handwriting on the wall. And the boss, his boss, who was there, head of the research, decided to go down to
And how long did you live in this house before you moved to Montreal?
1978 to 1970.
Because I think I met Bill when I was 15, so that was 65. And I remember coming to either Thanksgiving, Christmas, something
coming up with
here
him.
At
sure.
this house,
yeah.
And then moving to.
And even then, I did not intend to buy.
So you were still working in North Adams at that time. You went from
I worked here in Adams until. It closed in 1968.
I don't know if people realize that about you, all these different places that you've been.
I knew it, you have to work, however. And one day I told him, what made me do it? Well, in a way, I do. We had an engineer at the John Hooker Chemical who had suggested his wife worked in the schools. He's from Louisville.
Yeah.
jar. When I went out, I stopped in at the college, and I didn't know what kind of a business it was. I thought they were just professors, and you probably did what the professors worked as their clerks, you know. I didn't have the smallest idea. It was a huge office. Real office work. So that was in June, I believe, May or June. And Mr. Dino Thomas and Peter Cobble was near your mother. He was the one who hired then. And he said, there's nothing now. He said, but sometimes in September we have openings. So when September came, I called back. And I wasn't going to let him forget it. And he said, can you come in to work tomorrow?
Oh,
and I said, I can't because I want to get 2 weeks. And so I'm 2 weeks. And I said,
All right, well, I think we'll complete the circle. We'll go back to Arnold Ave.
Okay.
We're just going to say our fond farewell.
Oh.
Yeah, we're, you ready?
Yeah.
Okay. We're back at Arnold Ave. Made the full circle. Found out some things I didn't know today. Had a great, it's a beautiful day.
Gorgeous
great
day.
Morning.
Beautiful.
Worth the trip. So, you've lived here from 1968?
1970.
Planning on living here the rest of your life? Or?
As far as I'm concerned, the next move is...
As my father said, speed first.
Yeah.
Well, thank you for sharing your reminiscing with us.
Oh, that was
certainly
fun.
Enjoyed it. We'll have to go home and check the tape out. We may have to redo a few spots, but
probably edit it a little bit.
Be a great fall foliage excuse to get out and enjoy some of the nice fall weather.
Yeah.
So, anyway, okay.
I think we've had something.